Do you have Python scripts lying around and you wish that it could be converted into an interactive, data-driven web application? If you answered yes, then this video is for you because in this Streamlit 101 video, I'm going to show you how you could get started using Streamlit. And this is going to be a three-part series where in part one, I'm going to show you at a high level what Streamlit is all about. In part two, I'm going to show you how you could build a simple Streamlit application. And finally, in part three, I'm going to show you how you could make use of existing resources on Streamlit so that it will help you to get unstuck. And so without further ado, we're starting right now. Welcome to Streamlit 101. My name is Chanin Nantasenamat, and I'm a senior developer advocate at Snowflake working on Streamlit open source. In the data science or machine learning setting, deploying machine learning models is one of the highlights of a machine learning pipeline. And it is because, particularly, model deployment is the endpoint of a data science workflow. And what this means is that when machine learning models are built, deployed models will allow the end users, which could be stakeholders who are making use of your machine learning pipeline. And so such deployed models could be thought of as kind of like a machine learning as a service where users could interact with your models. And so typically models could be deployed in the form of a Jupyter Notebook, as an API, or also as a web application. So in this particular illustration that I've drawn, you can see that the machine learning model building process involves splitting your data, building the model, assessing whether your model performance is of satisfactory level. And if it is, then you could perform model interpretation. And if not, then you could go back to the model building process and improve the model. And aside from interpreting the models, what you want to do is you want to deploy the model. And in doing so, that will allow end users, like non-technical users, to be able to play with the model and provide you with feedback. And so this could be upper management, or it could be business analysts who could provide you with insights that you could use to improve the model further. And you can see here in this illustration that the model deployment as a web application requires a steep learning curve, in that it requires you to spend time learning a web framework, which might require lengthy coding in order to create a minimum viable product. However, Streamlit allows you to create such MVPs with minimal coding, which you'll be learning in this Streamlit 101 series. And after you have created your web app, you could upload it to the cloud so that other community users could make use or benefit from your Streamlit application. And so in a nutshell, building web applications traditionally requires you to use frameworks such as Django and Flask if you're working in a Python environment. And this requires a steep learning curve and a big time investment. And as already mentioned, Streamlit allows you to perform minimal coding in order for you to get a working web application. And if you already know Python, then using Streamlit is going to be easy. And for new beginners of Python, no worries, because in this video and Streamlit 101 series, you're going to see how easy it is to go from scratch to a working application and sharing it with your community. So a little bit about Streamlit. Streamlit is a Python library that allows you to convert data scripts into a shareable web applications, literally in minutes or hours for more complicated web applications. As mentioned already, a typical web application requires a steep learning curve to get started, which might hinder beginners to Python. However, with Streamlit, there's no front-end experience required, and anyone who knows a basic level of Python could create a web application. So take a look at this particular example, where in only a few lines of code, you could generate this Streamlit application, which allows users to select a particular forecast windows in days and make the prediction. So the only prerequisite to using Streamlit is to have a working knowledge of Python at the basic level. In a nutshell, the creation of a Streamlit application essentially requires you to create a script that performs a specific task. For example, if you would like to combine Excel files, then you would write a script that will iterate through the Excel file list, read it, and then write the contents out. And so such data scripts could be embedded inside a Streamlit application. And a point of note here is that you could build the Streamlit application in increments. And that means that you could start with a very simple Hello World application, and then you could slowly add interactive widgets to it, add data frames, add file uploaders, add output widgets, etc. So the application doesn't have to be built in one sitting. You could grow it incrementally, and it will evolve. Let's take a look at the Python data ecosystem. Here you can see that Streamlit is compatible with all of the Python data ecosystem, like the data visualization libraries, Bokeh, Altair, Matplotlib, VegaLite, VecGL. It also supports popular machine learning and deep learning frameworks like scikit-learn, TensorFlow, PyTorch, Keras, and data wrangling library like Pandas. And so you could import all of these Python libraries into your Streamlit application and build an interactive, data-driven app. If you need inspiration when creating your Streamlit app, you can take a look at the Streamlit gallery, which categorizes and curates the popular Streamlit applications according to topics, and you could browse through them for ideas and inspiration. And there's also links to the code and the demo app for you to play around with. Streamlit has become popular for data science as it allows you to add a UI interface to your existing Python scripts. And here are some examples of data teams using Streamlit. In essence, Streamlit is based on three simple principles. And the first one is embrace scripting. You could build an app in only a few lines of code with the magically simple API of Streamlit. And as you build the code and as you save the file, you could automatically see in real time how your application is evolving. Second principle is weave interaction. Adding widgets is as simple as defining a variable. There's no need to write a backend, define routes, handle HTTP requests, connect a front end, write HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And so all of the heavy lifting is done by the Streamlit Python library. The third principle is you could effortlessly build the app and share the app with the community. And this is free for the Streamlit Community Cloud. However, if you require additional resources, you could also self-host your own web server for the Streamlit applications. Installing Streamlit is very simple. You could use pip or conda. For instance, when using pip, you could do pip install Streamlit, and after the installation process is complete, you could type in Streamlit hello, and this will bring up a example demo app for you to play around with. Likewise, to install Streamlit in conda, you could type in conda install-c conda-forge Streamlit. And after installation is complete, you could do the same thing. You could type in Streamlit hello, and it will bring up the demo app. Let's take a look at how you could code a Streamlit application. Firstly, a very simple Streamlit application could start off as a single app file. However, when your app grows in complexity and you want to add additional files or additional pages to your apps, that is essentially just adding an additional app file. Also, check out the documentation for additional information on how you could build both single-page application in Streamlit and also multi-page app in Streamlit. So links will be provided in the video description. Inside the app file, your import Streamlit as ST, and then you could use any of the input widgets that are available for you in the Streamlit command API, and also any of the output widgets. Here, for example, you could use input widgets like buttons, radio buttons, select box, tick box, slider widgets for accepting user input, text input, and for output widgets, you could have data frames, you could have maps that are interactive, and there's so much more. So for a more comprehensive full list of all of the widgets, you could also check out this Streamlit API in the documentation. So links in the video description. And if this is your first time hearing about Streamlit and you would like to get started right away, you could also check out the educational learning challenge called the 30 Days of Streamlit. So in a nutshell, the 30 Days of Streamlit will teach you on how you could get started in using Streamlit. And what's the best way to learn about Streamlit is to build Streamlit applications. So the 30 Days of Streamlit draws its inspiration from several other coding challenges, like the one from Ken G, the 66 Days of Data, the 100 Days of Code, and also Kaggle's 30 Days of ML. The 30 Days of Streamlit was launched in April 1st, 2022, where a new challenge was released daily. But have no fear if you have missed out on this, because all of the learning challenges are compiled inside a 30 Days app. And so with this 30 Days Streamlit application, all of the lesson could be easily accessed for all the 30 days. And so you could also check out the link in the video description. And for each of the day that you're learning about Streamlit, for each of the daily challenge, please make sure to learn in public, whereby you could share your learning journey, what you have done, what you have learned, using the hashtag 30 Days of Streamlit. And you could share that on LinkedIn and also on Twitter. And also make sure to tag the Streamlit account by using @Streamlit. And so who can participate in the 30 Days of Challenge, you might ask? Well, everyone. Everyone who has a basic knowledge of Python could easily get started using Streamlit. If you're into this type of content, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and like the video. Thank you for watching until the end of the video. If you enjoyed part one, then make sure to continue and watch part two. And so I'll see you in the next video.